Good morning everyone, welcome again to our channel Learn Data Science with Pranjal. In this video we will learn how to create pivot table in pandas. We all must have created the pivot in Excel and interpreted the data. In this video we will see different ways in which we can create the pivot table in our pandas and also to do the subtotaling, and at the end we will also see how to create the graph on a pivot table. So watch the video till the end. And if this is your first visit to the channel, please click on the subscribe button so that you do not miss any other knowledge video on the data science. In this video, our aim would be to build up pivot tables and how to apply our group by functions. I have read my file. Let's quickly discuss how my data looks like. I have loan ID, gender, married, dependent, education. These are the name of my columns. There are 13 columns, 769 rows. Value count function will give me the count of each levels within a particular category. So in gender, I'm having two categories, male and female. So it's giving me the count, how many males, how many females. So there were 624 males and 145 females. Then what I can do, I can group by the gender. I'm grouping based upon the gender. Gender is my categorical column and applicant income is the another column. If we can quickly have that applicant income. So applicant income is another column. Applicant income is my numeric column. I am finding the mean of my numeric column based upon the gender. So I get two means. 4589.641379 is the mean applicant income, but only for the females. 5207.579 is mean applicant income, but only for the males. In previous line, only the mean was being calculated. In this line, apart from the mean, count, min, max is also being calculated. So again, I have the values for males and females, but this time I do not get just mean. I also get my maximum, minimum and the count. In this line, I have not specified on which particular column I want to find my count, min, max and mean. So it's giving me count, min, max for each and every numeric column. So that we can see it's giving for dependent, applicant income, co-applicant income, loan amount and loan amount term, credit history, everything. Here I'm creating in a way a pivot table. I'm passing my three categories. So gender is the categorical data, married is the categorical data, self-employed is the categorical data. And only your applicant mean is your numeric data. I'm cutting this kind of table. So in gender, I have two levels, male and female. In married, I have two levels, no and yes. In self-employed, again, I have two levels, no and yes. So for each level, I am getting my data. This 4044 represents the mean income of female who are not married and not self-employed. This 8323 represents the mean income of females who are not married and are self-employed. Similarly, if I take this number, 6758, this represents the mean income of the males who are not married, but they are self-employed. In this line, instead of using my mean, I am using my size. So size gives me the count. How many people under each category? 86. So there are 86 females who are not married and who are not self-employed. This 44 represents the number of females who are married and not self-employed. So using my size function gives me the count. In this line and in this line, the only difference is I have used my unstack function. So my representation has changed. So previously my married and self-employed were different column, but now married has become a kind of level in my self-employed. Pivot table. For creating the pivot table, the function I am using is pd.pivottable. Let's discuss this code. I want to create a pivot table on my CR data frame. What should be my index? Gender and married are my indexes. What function do I wish to apply? I wish to apply my mean function. So if we do shift tab, then we can see number of functions. Aggregate function can take number of functions. So it can take your mean, it can take your median and number of functions. It can take your... So using my gender and married, I have applied my mean function. So gender and married. Applicant income. So it's giving the breakup for each and every category. In previous examples, I have not passed any particular column, but in this example, I'm passing a particular column. I'm saying value is equal to applicant income. Now, when I build my pivot table, I get the values only for that particular column, which I have mentioned in my values. So I am getting the total for my applicant income. 4530 represents the mean applicant income for females who are not married. Let's try to understand this line. PT.pivot table. I want to build a pivot table on this CR data frame. Value is equal to applicant income. Applicant income is my numeric data. Index, gender and married. Gender and married is my categorical data. On gender and married, I want to build my index. Aggregate function is my mean. So I have taken mean. It depends upon the scenario. I could have taken median, sum, whatever. Columns equal to credit history. I get my gender, male and female, because I have used index over here. So this gender and married become my index. Column equal to credit history. So 0 and 1. In credit history column, if we check, there are only two levels, either 0 or 1. So this kind of result I get. How do I read my result? If I take any particular value, so 4378 is your mean applicant income for females who are married and their credit history is 0. Similarly, your 5238 indicates your mean applicant income for the males who are married and their credit history is 1. Let's see a different way in which we can build a pivot table. So again, pt.pivot table. I want to build a pivot table on this data frame. Values, applicant income. This applicant income is my numeric data. Index, gender and married. Gender and married are my categorical data. So on that, I can create my gender. Aggregate function, what type of function you want to apply. And columns. Now, I'm not taking one column, but I'm taking more than one column. I'm taking two columns. I'm taking credit history and I'm taking dependents. So credit history, there are two things, 0 and 1. And in dependents, you have your 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So index, I have said gender and married. So gender and married come over here, index part. And rest, everything becomes my column. So credit history takes two values, 0 and 1. And dependents, there are four dependents. There are four categories inside your dependent. So I get this type of table. How do I interpret my table? Let's take any value. So I take this value, 7667. So this represents your mean applicant income when the for the female category who are not married and they have your one dependent. How do I read this value? 3926. It represents your mean applicant income for males who are married and they have your two dependents. Let's discuss our code. So again, pd.pivot table, CR values. The only change here is I have shuffled my columns. So I have previously I had taken credit history first and dependent. Now I'm taking dependent, comma credit history. So my output becomes something like this. So dependent becomes your first level. And within your dependents, you have your credit history. Okay, I'm creating another pivot table, table 3, pd.pivot table. Creating the pivot table on the same data frame. Values is my applicant income. Index, loan amount, term. Aggregate function equal to mean. Index is loan amount term. Loan amount term for how many months the people are taking loan. So people have taken loan for 6 months, 12 months, 36 months, 60 months, all those things. I get this type of table. Now using this table, I can also create my graph. Let's quickly see how to create my graph. The first line, figure equal to plt.figure size 10, 10. This I have used to increase the size of the plot. If you want, you can change the number. So instead of using 10, 10, you can use your 11, 11 or 5, 5. It depends how big the size of the plot you want. plt.plot, I'm saying table3.index and table3.value. So table 3 is the table which I have already created. Let's quickly see what's my index looks like. When I say table3.index, I can see. So index is my 6, 12, 36, 60, 84, 120, all those things. Why? Because these were my part of my loan amount term. So all those becomes my index values. Similarly, I can check my values. So values are my 28751080, which is the same I am getting over here. Okay. So values and index. So index is basically your loan amount term, and values are basically your applicant income. Now I plot them. plt.plot, table 3 index, table 3 values, marker equal to star, color equal to G, stands for your green. So this is the plot I get. Loan amount term versus income. It's the name of the title which I have passed. Terms in month. PLT X label, whatever has been passed in your terms in months. PLT.Y level, income in dollars. This has been printed over here. Color equal to G. My graph is in green color. If you give your color equal to R, your graph would be in your red color. So it depends what type of color you wish to have. Marker equal to star. So wherever the values change, I have put the marker. So in this graph, we can see what's the relation between my income and loan amount term. We have already built a pivot table. The below lines of code is when I want to add some kind of subtotal. Let's see how can I add my subtotals to it. I'm creating a pivot table which looks something like this. Index are my gender and merit. Aggregate function is my mean. Margin equals to true. Margin name, grand total. We have already seen this part of code. Now my aim is that I want to add the subtotals for gender category. So after your female, I should get an extra line which displays me the total for females. And at the end, I should also get the lines which displays me the total for males. So to do that, I have written a small piece of code. Let's quickly see this. Okay. Fetch the totals for the female category. Similarly, I am doing it for my male category. It looks something like this. Now when we check our original table, we will see that female total and male total have been added. This star is coming. Why? Because I have added a star over here. In this table, subtotals, female total, male total have been added. But the only problem till now is that the female total and male total are coming at the end. Female total should come after these two lines. So what I'll do, I'll reshuffle my rows. Now I'm reshuffling my rows. So I'm saying 0, 1. I want these two lines. And then I'm saying 5. After my 0 and 1 rows, I want my female total. So I've set 5. 2, 3. After that, I want no and yes, male, no and yes. Then I want my 6th line. I want male total and then my grand total. Now when we see that, we'll see that I have the totals for female, no and yes, and at the end I have female total. Once your female category is over, then your male category starts. After your male category, you have your male totals and then you have your grand total. So we have added the subtotals and we have shifted the rows accordingly. In this table, we have seen our grand total, we have seen the totals for category male and female. But what if I also want to add the subtotals for my married category? So the below portion of code is if you want to add the subtotal for your married category. What I have done is I have created another table name as your table 2. This is my table 2. So from table 2, I am extracting the totals for the married yes and married no. And I am attaching it to my original table. So original table already had my male, female and all the other totals. I am attaching back it to my original table. And now when we look at our table, we get table something like this. So the only problem over here is that my married total is coming at the last. It should be coming little bit above your grand total. So what I'm doing, I'm reshuffling my rows. So table dot ilog 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 6. After this, I get my married total as my yes and no. First of all, I have the female category. Wherever your female category is over, I am getting my female total. After female total, I have the male category. Where my male category is getting over, I am getting my male totals. And then I have the married total. Married yes, no. And at the end, I have my grand total. Let's build a pivot table on some another data also. So this is my office supply data where I have region, representatives, item, unit, unit price. So regions, there are east region, central region, and your west region. Representatives, the name of the representatives who are doing the business. Item sold. Item sold, what were the items sold? Pen, binder, pencil, dex, whatever. How many units were sold? And what was the price at which they were sold? Let's try to build a pivot table on this. This data set has your 43 records and 6 columns. I'm building a pivot table. Office supply is the name of the data frame. Index I'm using is region and item. So you have 3 regions, east, central, and west. Items, there are number of items. Aggregate function I'm using is mean. Margin, this is the table. So this is how my table looks like. I have the region, central region, east region, west region. And within the regions, I have the item. So these were the items which were sold. Binder, dex, pen, pen set, pencil. Unit price, the unit price and how many units. Mean unit price and mean unit sold. Let's try to add the subtotal. Once my central, this portion gets over, I want to add the subtotal for central region. Similarly, after your east region, I want to add the subtotal for east and for the west. OPP sub tab, so your office supply table. Location central dot sum. So when I'm saying central dot sum, it takes this thing and does the sum. Similarly, your office supply table location east. So summary of your east and similarly your summary of the west. Summary of your west. So after running these 3 lines, when we check our table, we see that central total, east total, and west total have been added. And the name is coming from over here, central total, east total, and west total. Whatever name we have given over there, the same name is being reflected over here. In this table, the subtotals have already been created, but the only issue till now is that the central total, east total, and west total are coming at that. Actually, my central total should be coming before my east start, and the east total should be coming before my west start. So what I am doing, I have just reshuffled my data frame. I have rearranged my rows in the data frame. I am saying 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. I do not want any change till over here, till pencil. And then, so after pencil, my central total should be coming here. So I am moving this row. I am moving my central total after my pencil. So that's why I reshuffled my data. So I reshuffle my data, and after reshuffling my data, I get this type of table. Central, within the central region, these were the items sold. And at the end, I get the total score for the central region. And similarly for your east region, these were the items sold in your east region. And at the end, I get my east total. And similarly, I get my west total. This brings us to the end of the video. I am sure you liked the video and it would actually help you in your work. Hope to see you soon in my next video. Till that time, happy learning.